Are you struggling with case selection? Perhaps you don't know what cases you should submit. Choosing the right selection of cases is critical to crack RCA. Each case can score up to 18 marks, which can make all the difference between a pass and a fail. Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Dr. Erwin Kwun. I'm on a mission to help doctors lead a happy and fulfilling life. Today we're going to talk about RCA case selection, what cases to avoid, what cases to submit, how to fulfill the mandatory case selection criteria. It's important that you ensure your submission meets the requirements set by the college. First thing first, let's go over the mandatory case selection criteria. You need to have a case involving a child age 16 years or younger. This could also be a consultation done by proxy with a parent or carer. You need to make sure that you have a case involving an older adult over 65 years old. You need to make sure that you have an acute problem that needs urgent investigation or referral. You need to make sure that you have a maternal and reproductive health case. You need to make sure that you have a mental health condition. This is a diagnosis within the DSM or ICD classifications. Last but not least, you need to make sure that you have a case about a long-term condition. This could be cancer, multimorbidity, or disability. I highly recommend that you focus on recording these cases first so that you meet the requirement. Let's jump right into the first case. Case involving a child age 16 years or younger. What are the cases that are unlikely to score well for this criteria? Simple cases that are straightforward, such as verruca or nappy rash, are unlikely to score well because these consultations have limited opportunity in demonstrating capabilities for RCA due to a lack of complexity. Other cases that might not do well are, for example, if you are seeing a patient who is a 15-year-old boy presenting with sore throat and you diagnose of tonsillitis, or a 15-year-old girl presenting with dysuria for 3 days and you diagnose of UTI. Such consultations may not reflect the impact of patient being a child. With a teenager presenting with tonsillitis or UTI, the fact that the patient is a child is simply incidental to the case. So what are suitable cases that will fulfill a case involving a child age 16 years or younger? Suitable cases include enuresis, reflux in babies, contraception, meningitis, anxiety, and abdominal pain. It's very important that you ensure that you're involving the child if they're old enough, as you need to show that you have the capabilities of consulting pediatric case and showing that you can interact and make a safe assessment of a pediatric problem. The next case is one involving an older adult over 65 years old. What cases are unlikely to score well? Follow-up cases are known to score low, so avoid any follow-up cases. What you want is to avoid any cases where there's a patient who you've seen before or who has already been seen for this problem and you're going to do a follow-up. Low clinical challenge cases, or where there's absence of complicating factors, for example, thrush or eczema, are unlikely to score well. On the opposite side, high challenge cases with multiple complicating factors may be too complex to manage within 12 minutes, so you're unlikely to score well if it's too challenging. So what are suitable cases you could select? Suitable cases include dementia, insomnia — this is quite common in elderly population — anxiety and depression related to loneliness, polypharmacy, dizziness or giddiness, falls and fragility fractures. Musculoskeletal problem is also a good one for this criteria. So a patient who is presenting with osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, back pain and gout, angina, heart failure, stroke or hypertension. Other cases include end-of-life care and DNA CPR discussion. The next case is an acute problem that needs urgent investigation or referral. What are the cases unlikely to score well for this criteria? If you overcomplicate a simple case and try to drag it to 12 minutes, then you're unlikely to score well because examiners can see what you're doing and it's very painful for them when they're reviewing a recording. Well, this is a simple, straightforward consultation and they find that a candidate is trying to overcomplicate it. Cases where you are referring to hospital without discussion of the benefits and the risk and you're delegating the management to the secondary care team, then because there's not much evidence in the consultation, you're unlikely to score well. Cases where you're not involving your patient in management decision is also one where you're unlikely to score well, because it's very important that you make sure that you involve your patient and have a discussion with them. So what are suitable cases for this criteria? Same day admission to secondary care. This would include ischemic heart disease, thunderclap headache, pyelonephritis, GI bleed, acute abdomen and sepsis. Urgent referral to secondary care. These include TIA or obstructive sleep apnea. A USC referral under the 2-week wait pathway also falls under this criteria. Case involving a patient who presents with red flag symptom, such as dysphagia, hemoptysis, or unintentional weight loss that warrants 2-week wait referral. This would be a good one as well. Last but not least is if you're arranging urgent investigation. If you need to arrange urgent investigation, then this would also be considered as an acute case. The next case is a maternal and reproductive health. It is worth mentioning that breast lump is no longer considered for this criteria apart from those associated with the postnatal period. Cases unlikely to score well include straightforward consultation involving contraception requests or simple pill check that could easily be done by a practice nurse. On the opposite side, menopause is a high challenge case with a lot to cover. It may be too complex to manage within 12 minutes. So what are the suitable cases for this criteria? It's very important to think about the level of complexity and the challenge of a case. So suitable cases include maternity care, pre, intra and postnatal issues, both physical and mental. For example, preeclampsia, nausea and vomiting in pregnancy, postnatal depression. This would be a good one for maternity care. Sexual health is also under this category. So you could submit a case of emergency contraception, infections such as HIV and sexually transmitted infection for all genders. Gynecological problems also fall under this category, so cases involving vaginal bleeding problems, endometriosis, or vaginal prolapse. The next case involves mental health condition within the DSM or ICD classifications. What are the cases unlikely to score well? Follow-up review of antidepressant medication is unlikely to score well because it is straightforward and low clinical challenge. Fit note request is another case where you're unlikely to score well. What are the suitable cases you could submit for this criteria? Cases include new diagnosis of depression or patient who has depression for many years and is coming back because there has been deterioration in the mental health with suicidal ideas, and you need to manage this patient and possibly refer to crisis team, patient presenting with anxiety, work-related stress, bipolar disorder. It's vital that you show your capabilities to make a safe assessment of a psychiatric problem and also carry out a risk assessment. Last but not least is a case involving a long-term condition. It is important to define what a long-term condition is for the purpose of the RCA. This is defined as any pre-existing medical condition that cannot currently be cured but can be managed with the use of medication or approaches and therapies. It should be an established diagnosis in the patient. This criteria does not include a potential long-term condition which is being considered or diagnosed for the first time. What are cases unlikely to score well? Simple diabetic annual review that could have been carried out by a practice nurse, or simple COPD review that a practice nurse would usually carry out. It's important that you think about choosing a case that will give you opportunities to show your skills as a safe and independent GP. So a case that is of moderate challenge and has some level of complexity. What are suitable cases? Suitable cases include cancer. You could cover the psychosocial components of a diagnosis of cancer. You could cover the side effects of undergoing chemotherapy and the need for anti-sickness. Complications of a long-term condition such as diabetes. So this would include foot ulcer or chronic kidney disease. Exacerbation of COPD with complicating factors. This could be complicating factors related to patient expectation. If a patient is expecting to have a nebulized salbutamol or oxygen, then you need to show your negotiation skills. Other long-term conditions include Crohn's disease, diverticular disease, heart failure, and osteoarthritis impacting on the patient's mobility. Would you like to have a copy of the Blueprint case selection? This is a PDF file that you could hand to your receptionist so they can book suitable cases for your recording. Click the link down in the description box to download your free copy. A strategy you could use to ensure you have the right selection of cases is to focus on a case selection criteria each week. For example, let's say this week you want to make sure you have a pediatric case, then inform the practice manager, inform the receptionist and the GPs who work at the practice that you're aiming to get a pediatric case this week. So let them know and they'll be able to book patients who fulfill that criteria. If you're practicing your history taking, focusing on pediatric problems, and if you can be more specific as to if you want to cover for GERD or constipation, and you refine your consultation for this type of problem, then you're more likely to score well for this case because you're likely to get a very good case. Ideally, you want to be in a position where you have three cases of constipation or three cases of reflux in a baby. Then you can select the best one among. So this is how you will be able to get the selection of cases. So you can do that for each of the mandatory selection criteria. When you're approaching the time for submission, it's very important to take some time to sit down, to look at all the cases that you've got that are possible submission, and then you score them. It's very important that you're objective in your assessment of the cases and are conservative in the way that you're marking it. So make sure that you assess each case and then you rank them so that you know which of the cases are the winners and which of the cases you're not too sure are going to do well. If you want me to do a video specifically on marking, then let me know down in the comment section. If you've made it this far, then I've got another video that I'm sure you're going to find useful. This is a video where a registrar who passed the RCA first attempt shows how she managed to get more cases. Click the video to watch it. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.